In quantum mechanics, it's always important to make sure the wave function you're dealing with is correctly normalized. In this video, we will tell you why this is important and also how to normalize wave functions. First off, why do we need to normalize wave functions? According to the Born interpretation of quantum mechanics, the absolute square of a wave function gives us the probability density of where to find the corresponding particle. This absolute square here can be calculated by multiplying the complex conjugate of psi with the regular psi. Now, in order to go from a probability density to a probability, we need to integrate. So, if we're interested in the probability to find the particle between the points A and B, we need to integrate the probability density from A to B. What about the probability to find the particle anywhere? That is, what if we integrate from minus infinity to plus infinity? The particle has to be somewhere, so if we're looking everywhere, we will 100% find it. In other words, this integral must be equal to 1. And that's exactly the normalization condition. The particle must be somewhere, so if we look everywhere, we find it with a probability of 100%. Let's look at some examples to better understand the normalization of wave functions. First, consider this wave function. It is given by a times the sine of 2x if x is between minus pi and pi. Everywhere else, the wave function is 0. This means the wave function might look something like this, depending on the size of a. But not all values of a lead to a normalized wave function. The normalization condition now tells us to integrate the absolute square of psi from minus infinity to plus infinity. We can separate this integral into three parts, since the wave function behaves differently in each part. Fortunately, the first and last integrals are 0, simply because the wave function itself is 0. And the integral in the middle can be written as the absolute square of a times the integral from minus pi to pi over the sine squared of 2x dx. Whatever this is, it must be equal to 1. The result of this integral is pi. So we can deduce that the absolute square of a must be equal to 1 over pi. This means that the absolute value of a must be equal to 1 over the square root of pi. Now, this is usually as far as we can go, because the normalization condition only helps us to determine the absolute value of a. If we want to write down a itself, we must include a phase factor where phi can be any real number. In this way, the absolute value of the phase factor is equal to 1, and we get this equation again. Our final result for the wave function therefore looks like this. For our next example, we will use the bra-ket formalism, where the normalization condition is simply given by bra psi times ket psi is equal to 1. If you already know some quantum mechanics, you can show that by inserting a completeness relation, this condition is exactly the same as the one we wrote at the beginning of this video, but this is not important for the calculation itself. In this example, psi is given by 3 times up plus 2i times down, where these up and down states can for instance denote the two spin states of a spin 1/2 particle. In any case, the only thing we need to know is how these up and down states are related to each other. We will assume that up up and down down are equal to 1, and that up down and down up are 0. This is what's called an orthonormal basis. Now, normalizing such a ket state is actually quite simple, but let's do each step slowly. First, we need the corresponding bra state to our ket state. This bra psi is given by complex conjugating the coefficient of each ket and then switching each ket state to a bra state. So the only thing to watch out for is the minus sign here. The second step is to compute the bra ket product of psi with itself. After multiplying the brackets, you see why we need the relations of up and down with each other. Therefore, we know that only 2 terms remain, which add up to 13. Now, this should be equal to 1 for a normalized wave function, so the bra-ket product is 13 times bigger than what we need it to be. In fact, if we write this as psi psi over 13 being equal to 1, you can see that if we divide the bra and ket by the square root of 13, then the new wave function psi tilde will be normalized. The final result is Psi tilde is equal to 3 over the square root of 13 times up plus 2i over the square root of 13 times down. As a final example, let's take the quantum harmonic oscillator with the wave function 2 times 0 plus the square root of 5 times I times 1 plus 4 over I times 4. These ket states are related to each other such that the Bra-ket product of the same number is equal to 1, and any Bra-ket product of different numbers is 0. Again, this is called an orthonormal basis. In order to normalize this state, just follow these three steps. First, find the Bra state of psi. Second, calculate the Bra-ket product of psi with itself. Let's say the result is A. Third, write down the normalized wave function psi tilde as 1 over the square root of A times psi. Try to do this yourself, and if you're ready, here is the solution. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.